So you're thinking of moving to Billings, Montana? In this video, I'll take you for a virtual drive through the West End of Billings. We'll check out this area using a Google map, and I'll answer some questions along the way, like, what's there to do in the West End? Where can I shop? Where can I eat? Where are the schools located? How about medical and dental? I'll walk you through all of that, then stick around to the end because I'll share information about a new recreational area coming to the West End of Billings. So, let's get started. Hey, if this is your first time to the channel and you want to know everything there is about living in Billings, Montana and the surrounding area, then subscribe below. Tap the bell for notifications so you can be the first to learn about the current market in Billings, Montana. My name is Nancy Brook with Billings Best Real Estate, and the team and I get calls, texts, and emails every single day from people just like you looking to make their move to Billings, Montana, and we absolutely love it. So whether you're moving in 9 days or 90 days, give us a call, shoot us a text, send us an email, or schedule a Zoom meeting. All of the information is in the description below. We're here for you and want to help you make that smooth move to Billings, Montana. So like I said, today we're checking out Billings West End using a Google map. So let's switch views so you can see inside my computer. Well, hello everyone. Welcome to my computer. We are going to do a tour of the West End here on a Google map. So in general, this is of course Billings, and Billings extends to the Heights all the way out west. So the West End of Billings begins around 6th Street West, which is right around here. It goes down to King Avenue, and then it extends all the way out. Now, the West End, in terms of MLS category, so basically our multiple listing services, would go up to Grand Avenue. So all of this would be the West End. Up here is considered Northwest Billings. So it is sometimes called the West End, but just so you know the difference. And today we're just going to be focused on this area right west of downtown and not quite up to the rims. So let me go ahead and clear this. And the first thing I want to talk about, a lot of people want to know, how do I get to the airport from the West End? So let's talk about that. The airport is up on top of the rims, and there's two ways to get to the airport. So the first way is Zimmerman Park, which a lot of people take that if they live on the West End. So basically, if you live from here west, you would likely take Zimmerman Trail up to the rims. And then you tie into Highway 3, and there you are at the airport. If you're more in Midtown, your house is in Midtown, you would head up to the airport by hooking onto North 27th and then heading on up until you see the airport. So probably anywhere on the West End, it's going to take maybe 10 to 15 minutes to get to the airport. So that is the airport. Let's next talk about shopping. And I'm going to zoom in for this, and I'm going to just do a little Google search that says shopping Billings, Montana. And let's see what comes up here. So the main shopping areas are in the West End, and there's three centers or shopping centers. So the first one is called Shiloh Crossing. That is over King Avenue West and Shiloh Road. The second one is called Rimrock Mall. And I'm not sure if it's showing up on this map, but it is, well, it's right here. You can see all the stores over there. It's right on Central and 24th Street. And the third shopping center is over here on Grand Avenue. You can see some of the stores. And 16th Street, and that is called West Park Promenade. So let me cover each of those areas. So first off, if you like shopping, which I know a lot of people love to shop, the West End is really the place for you. So in the West End, we have some major box stores. So if you notice here, I'll mark some of these. We've got Costco, we've got Best Buy, Home Depot. Across the street here, I'm gonna zoom in a little bit just so you can see it. For some reason, it doesn't sometimes show up unless I zoom in a little more. Across the street, you will see a lot more shopping as well. So we've got the World Market here. We've got Applebee's. There is a Walmart here, which for some reason isn't showing up, and I don't know why. So that's the main box store area. This King Avenue, right around 24th Street, all the way to 29th Street. If we take King Avenue further west and hit Shiloh Road, then we'll hit this Shiloh Crossing area. And there are a lot of stores here. You've got the Shields, which is a regional sporting goods store. It's pretty cool in there. They have everything you could want, even a cool fish tank that the kids could look at. We've got a Kohl's, and then there's a lot of smaller shops in here. There's Dennis, there's AMC 14 Theater Movie right in that area. That is the newest mall, and it's one that is an outside type mall, so you don't go inside and walk around the mall. Everything has its own entrance. So let's head up a little bit, and the next one we'll cover is Rimrock Mall. Rimrock Mall is Central and 24th Street. You can see a JCPenney's on it. There's a Dillard's. There's a lot of stores. Now, this is an indoor mall, and it has been around since the mid-70s. I think it was 75 when it came to be. And if we continue up north, I mentioned West Park Promenade. It used to be called West Park Plaza, and that was really the first indoor mall, but it was really quite small compared to Rimrock Mall when it got built. So you'll notice it right here between 15th and 17th Street. That's where that mall is located. They have a number of local retailers you'll find in there. And a couple that I'll give a shout out to, well, is Timeout Sports. And you can't really see it on this map, but Timeout Sports is right around, you go through the main entrance and it's right back here. And the Timeout Sports is pretty cool because they have shoes for basically any kind of sport you could want. So a lot of running shoes, I've gotten my weightlifting shoes there. You can find pretty much everything there. So I would highly recommend that store. So that covers the shopping. Now, another question is, where can I eat? So let me just pull up some restaurants to give you an idea of where they're all located. So if we look on the West End, you'll see a lot of restaurants. So in that, since we're up here in the West Park Promenade, we have a Red Robin there. We've got the Midway Grill and Brews. If you go further west on Grand, there is a really nice restaurant called Enzo's, which is fine dining. It's delicious. There's a Montana pizza company called McKinsey River Pizza. They have locations in a few different places in Billings. I know for sure in the Heights. And over on Shiloh, there are some additional restaurants. We've got Local Kitchen and Bar, which is pretty neat place. And let's zoom out a little bit. We've got a Thai restaurant, an Indian restaurant, another Thai restaurant, another Thai restaurant. And then you can see more of the chain restaurants like Texas Roadhouse and Fuddruckers. Taco Bell, McDonald's, all of those are on that King Avenue area. So if you just see all of these red spots on the map, those are all dining. So pretty much anywhere you live in Billings will be fine dining. Or fast food if you like that. So let's talk a little bit about schools. You can see here, we have a lot of neighborhood elementary schools. So the main schools I'm going to talk about are West High, which is right in the center of the West End. We have two middle schools on the West End. So we've got Lewis and Clark, and we also have Will James, which for some reason I'm not seeing right now. But let me zoom in. So we can see Will James on the map. And that's over it's kind of over in this area. There we go. There's Will James Middle School. And then there's a lot of neighborhood elementary schools. So you can see no matter where you live, you have a neighborhood school nearby. Let's talk a little bit about clinics in the West End. So you'll see we have a Billings Clinic West on the West End. There's also a St. Vincent's Healthcare Clinic, which I'm not seeing for some reason. There's a children's clinic. The grocery stores have little clinics now in the Albertsons. So there's a neighborhood clinic no matter where you live. Let's zoom out a little bit more once again. And now I'm just going to give you a general sense of the different neighborhoods on the West End. I don't want to bore you by going on into too much detail, but in general, I mentioned, you know, this is downtown. So the West End starts right around here and goes all the way out. So this area is kind of considered just west of downtown. And when you get in the middle of town, that's considered Midtown. And as you get to 24th Street, that's just a lot of neighborhoods from the 50s, 60s, 70s. And then out here, after you get to Shiloh Road, is a lot of new construction. So I'll just write new. So depending on where you want to live, if you live closer to downtown, these houses that are not in the historic district, but just a little bit west of there, you can find some older houses from the 20s, 30s, 40s. So they're a little less expensive, a little smaller, might have two bedrooms, one bath in some cases. As you get more into Midtown, you'll find a variety of houses and a lot of mid-century modern type styles. And then when you get to that 24th Street area, those houses tend to be 50s, 60s, some 70s. And then as I mentioned, new construction continues on. You'll find from the 1990s all the way to the 2020s in this area. So Billings continues to expand, which was once a bunch of pastures in town, has now become subdivisions. So we really have seen quite a bit of change. So that's what I'm going to cover today on our map. I hope you enjoyed taking that little virtual dive with the Google map. Well, thank you for watching to the end. So here's that information about the new recreational area coming soon. Billings West End will have a new reservoir, which will be three times the size of Lake Elmo in the Heights. Now, the purpose of the reservoir is to provide water for the city, but it will also allow recreation, including swimming, boating, and walking paths around the reservoir. It will be located on either side of Hesper Road from Shiloh to 48th Street West. We hope you enjoyed touring Billings West End on a Google map. If you found this video helpful, be sure to like it and subscribe below. And remember, whether you're moving in 9 days or 90 days, give us a call, shoot us a text, send us an email, or schedule a Zoom meeting. All of the information is in the description below. And until next time, we hope to see you around town.